Hey guys, and welcome back to the Redeemed Marriage Podcast. I'm so excited you guys are here. On today's episode, we're going to be talking about Redbirds and what in the world Redbirds have to do with our marriage and what it can mean for you.
Hey, I'm Rusty.
And I'm Heather.
We're the Bryants with Three Strands Marriage Ministry, and this is the Redeemed Marriage Video Podcast.
We are here to encourage healthy marriages, strengthen wounded marriages, and begin the process of restoration to broken marriages.
We're not licensed counselors. However, we are a redeemed couple that loves the Lord and wants to help you journey through this messy, challenging, and fun part of life called marriage.
Hey guys, we didn't really know who was going to start that, did we? How about me? Hey, happy Valentine's.
It's Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's. It is actually Valentine's Day when we are recording this episode. Not only is it Valentine's, but we're in Mississippi. I know there's a lot of Mississippi listeners and watchers and viewers and all that, but there's people from all over too. And we're looking
Doesn't
at our
look like Mississippi out there.
It is ice, and it was 20 something degrees outside, which is crazy.
Tomorrow the low is 9.
9 degrees.
That's like a single digit.
Yeah, we don't know what to do around here. Nope. People go crazy. And so I guess we'll be stuck up in this house for a couple of days, but that's
That'll
okay
be fun.
Too. Yep. But with the weather like it is, it kind of ties in really good with what we're going to talk about today.
Yep.
So, okay, time out. Before, she didn't know I was going here.
Oh, great.
Can we tell them what you got me for Valentine's Day? So, I'm not a big gift person. I just don't really care that much if people give me gifts and stuff. And so she knows that. So she doesn't go out of her way for sure.
Which typically women don't give their husbands things on Valentine's anyway.
No, not really. Mm-hmm. But she walked into the room just before we started the video, and she was holding something up, and she said, "Happy Valentine's Day." I was like, "What in the world is that?" I walked over to it, and it was a Christmas present that she lost. And we had looked all over for it, and it was a light for the attic. I mean, really.
I mean, it was like a $25 light. It was a good light.
Very romantic Valentine's gift, but it was found, and we laughed and laughed about it. So anyway,
it was found.
Happy Valentine's. I got a Valentine's Day present. Didn't even know I was getting one. She didn't know I was getting one either. So, okay, enough of that. That was real life.
Real life.
So today we're going to talk a little bit about Redbirds and what that has to do with our marriage and what it can have to do with your marriage. Mm-hmm. So nine and a half years ago, we went to a marriage conference that Kurt Cameron.
It was so good.
Yeah, it was really good. Kurt Cameron and the guy that was leading the music. He sang a song that he wrote to his wife, and it was about Redbirds. Yep. So,
and it just became the theme in my mind for our marriage and for what that looked like. And I've been a Redbird fanatic since then. Bacon makes fun of me and says I'm the bird lady, but I just love Redbirds for what they symbolize. And you know, it was a big part of our marriage story and still is. But then when I got cancer, it kind of got adopted by my friends, that they were my Redbirds through that. And we even had t-shirts made that as a fundraiser, and on the very back it said Heather's Redbirds. Mm-hmm. And I collect Redbirds. Rusty asked where we wanted to sit today.
Here, move this way.
Yeah, all the Redbirds and people. My sweet friend Christy Henderson painted me this one. Her name's Eloise. And I just kind of collect them and put them around the house, and because it just has a beautiful symbol to me. So the song was written, like Rusty said, I was trying to think of the guy's name. Now I've gone. We should probably give him credit.
Mm.
It's Warren.
Mm-hmm. Barfield.
Barfield. B-A-R-F-I-E-L-D. Warren Barfield. And the song is beautiful. And it it talks about how in the winter that they're not, that redbirds are non-migrating. Thank you. They're non-migratory.
They don't migrate.
They don't migrate.
Don't make this harder than it has to be.
That's right. Most birds fly south for the winter. Like the birds up north, it's too cold, so they fly south. They get the heck out of Dodge because it's too cold.
And they all came here.
And it's cold now.
Yep.
But redbirds stay. That's why if you've ever seen pictures or if you live in the north where there's snow everywhere and you're just looking out across a yard with trees and everything, that the only birds that'll be there are those redbirds that just pop in that white surrounding, and those redbirds are just beautiful. And today I actually had two friends text me pictures of redbirds, and they were like, saw this in the backyard. I think they stand out a little bit more in the winter mm-hmm. when all this is going on, but just sent me a picture of a redbird in their backyard and just said, I was thinking about you and praying for you, because they associate that with my cancer journey. But to me, it is such a powerful picture of what you chose to be for me in our marriage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I actually went and did a little bit of research on redbirds, and they don't migrate, which means that they stay in one area. It actually says that most of them choose to stay within a mile of the nest where they were born. Mm-hmm. So they stay home, they stay close to home. The other thing is that they are monogamous, which means that they mate for life, for the most part. It was kind of funny because the article I was reading said they're a lot like humans, because humans are supposed to be monogamous, mm-hmm. but we don't always get it right, and so they're kind of the same way. But I thought it was really neat that they have found that the birds just choose to stay close to home. They choose a mate and they stay with that mate. They don't leave. They don't get in groups and head down south for the winter. They just stay. And so that song that he wrote was basically saying, you know, no matter what happens in your life, he wrote this to his wife. He said, no matter what happens, no matter what storms come along, no matter, you know, how hard things may seem, like, I'm not leaving you. I'm your redbird. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of the crux of the song, is that I'm going to be your redbird. And it just meant a lot to us as we were going through such a hard time in our marriage. And, you know, for me to, it really resonated, you know, with Heather. But to know that, like, that's what we're called to be in marriage, is we're called to be each other's redbirds.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you know, a lot of times people we meet with, and we've said this before on here, there's a lot of people we meet with, and I know we even said this, like, do I still love that person? Can you fall out of love with somebody? I just don't love him anymore. Somebody else would make me happy. He just doesn't make me happy anymore. That type thing. It's just such an easy thing to say and blow it off, and but that is not what God has called us to. Mm-hmm. You know, as redbirds stay, like you said, they stay through storms. They stay when times are tough. But they're always there in the good times too.
Mm-hmm.
And I just think that on this Valentine's Day, what a beautiful picture of remembering that we are committed. We made a vow between with our spouse and with God to stay with our spouse mm-hmm. even in the hard times, and to rediscover that love. Our pastor preached a whole message on what love is. You know, loving other people as you love yourself and as Christ loved us. And sometimes that's not easy.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes that's not easy to love your spouse in the hard times.
And the thing that he kept talking about is something that we've talked about over and over on this podcast, is that you know, love is a choice. There are emotions involved. He mentioned that this morning, and we've mentioned that over and over. Sure. You know, there's definitely, you know, those feelings of love, and, you know, when you fall in love with your spouse, mm-hmm. and all that. But for the most part, it really becomes a choice. Mm-hmm. And all of those things that the Bible says that love is, they're all things that you have to do. Like, mm-hmm. they don't just come naturally. And so, you know, as you're going through your marriage, and there comes those days when you're just like, you know, I just don't know if I, you know, have I fallen out of love? Do I really love my spouse? Well, that's your signal that you have to make the choice to love your spouse. And there's certainly going to be days when they do things, or they don't show that love in return. They do things that make you believe this is not worth fighting for. Mm-hmm. But we want to encourage you, even through all of that, to be the Redbird to your spouse, to be that one constant, the thing that says, you know, I'm not leaving, I'm sticking this out, and I'm gonna choose to love you no matter what.
That's right. So y'all be sure and go check out that song, Warren Barfield, or Barfield.
I don't know.
It's got to be Bar, because it's B-A-R, Field, Barfield.
Yeah.
Look it up. The name of the song, the album is Redbird, but the song is Redbird 2. Play that. And just remember that choosing your spouse, sometimes even when they don't deserve to be chosen,
mm-hmm.
just stay and honor God with that commitment.
Yep. So thanks for watching, and we hope that you'll follow us on our social media platforms and make sure you like and share. You know, we're learning through all this that the more that you share, the more people are able to watch it, because we can't reach everybody just through our, you know, social media friends and things like that. So make sure you share it, and hopefully somebody that really needs to hear this message will hear it. Yep. And till next time, we'll see you then.
Stay warm.